So this book is about, of course, Amir Khusrau, the man, and I think the man has left us so much literature that it's just unimaginable, in the sense that I don't think even 10% of the manuscripts that he has left have been translated into English from Persian. So there's a lot of work, you know, and so much volume of work that he has left in terms of information on the life and times of the 13th century. Yet, you know, after I had written my Dastan Goi presentation, and then I had also woven a musical narrative and worked in a documentary on Amir Khusrau, when I used to go to schools and, you know, mention the name of Amir Khusrau, kids would be like, who is this guy? And for me, that was like a shock. I was like, how can Amir Khusrau, the legendary, you know, poet, be unknown, be a riddle to the children? And that's when I thought, okay, if he's a riddle, you know, we must solve it together with children, because he was also, you know, someone who loved children, and he had left a lot of poetry which we hear that he used to play with children on street corners. And none of this poetry is written, in the sense that because it was in the oral tradition, and he usually wrote his collections in Farsi only, but a lot of Hindavi and Hindustani poetry, riddles and other things, songs that he wrote, were for the masses. They were not for the sultans who he was serving. So that's where the idea came up. Of course, Nimi, who is my editor for this book, she and I were having a conversation. She knew that there was work that I was doing in Dastan Goi and other fields. She said, why don't you talk about Khusrau in a children's book? And I was like, wow, you know, this is something that we can do. And it just went on from there. And the whole Penguin team, Devangana, Urmi, who has, you know, just made this book so much more beautiful than I thought it could become. It just became something which I think I really feel satisfied and proud of. I feel while Khusrau, of course, speaks about, you know, so many metaphysical concepts, and, you know, he talks about God, and he talks about love, and so many other things, about light, for example. And when he talks about these things, while there is something very profound that he is passing on as a message to the next generation, even his own children, his son, he gives advice to his son. Yet, he's very playful about all these things. And I was like, okay, you know, here is something which I think we need to go back to, a way of education where it is not instruction that is happening, but one generation is playing with another. And to me, I think that was a concept that also fit in the larger idea of solving the riddle of who Khusrau was. So each riddle, each, you know, couplet of poetry became a medium to unfold one aspect of Khusrau's personality. And it just became a series of riddles. At the end, we get to know the man Khusrau was, and along with that, what we do is we get to feel the taste of his poetry, especially those which were written for children. I think, yes, it was a very conscious decision to, you know, make children aware of or introduce them to Indian poetry, if I could say that, for two reasons. One, of course, is, you know, the how of it, and the other is the what of it. When I say the how of it, what I mean is that India has been a land of stories, and when we talk of stories here, we are talking about the oral tradition. And so poetry also has never really been a written form as much as it has been of poetry that has been recited orally, or rather, you know, read aloud or sung aloud. And riddles as a form of poetry especially have always been played as a community. And so I thought that, you know, why don't we make this book also a community exercise? I'll just give you an example. You know, I was here at the Bangalore Poetry Festival and doing a session for kids, where I said, okay, you know, we are not going to read these books, these poems, we'll sing them aloud. So kids followed me. So that gala kate to chuna kare muh se rakt bahaye so pyari baatein kare fikar katha dikhlaye. So this was the riddle, and everybody's thinking, and while all of them were giving, you know, so many answers and trying to guess, when I told them that the answer was paan, it came as a shock to me that many of the children there in the room did not even know what paan is. So when we talk about Indian poetry, I'm like, paan is such an Indian thing, I think, to begin with. In fact, Khusrau says that the most beautiful delicacy of Hindustan is paan. So there comes the what of it. So how do we bring these two things together? How is poetry to be enjoyed? How is it to be recited? How is it to be shared with? What is this poetry about? It's about things around us, the world around us. And if we forget that paan, which is such an essential part of our culture in all religions, not just in religion, you know, mythology, belief, things we eat, it's a day-to-day thing. So, yeah, I think that's why I thought that Khusrau and his riddles. I think what children will like most about the book is that how colorful it is. Like, every page of the book is a different color. And I think that for me represents the man that Khusrau was. He was a colorful man. And each riddle to me in this book is a different color of Khusrau's personality. So, and Urmi has, you know, like I said, made each page look so beautiful. And Devangana has, you know, designed it so beautifully that I think apart from reading the text of the book, just looking at the book makes you feel and that, you know, the time and age to which it belongs and what it, the colors also talk to you, I feel. So I think the kids will really enjoy that. I think as far as Amir Khusrau, the man in riddles, is concerned, just the fact that Khusrau was not just a poet, it's not just the field of literature that he works with. He's also a very important historical personality. And he participated in various other things like music and astronomy. So there is science also there. He's a very important political figure of his times. So there is, you know, politics also involved there. So I think each of these streams is where Khusrau features in as somebody who can communicate with children. So what I'm trying to say here is that one class using this book could only be about music. One class could only be about history. One class could only be about the times and the society and the culture of India that Amir Khusrau represents. But I mean, that said, apart from what this book covers, I think I'll come back to the basic idea of what a riddle is. And the idea of riddle or playing riddle shouldn't end with this book. I think if teachers, parents, librarians can encourage children to create their own riddles around what they see, you know, in their own world, that will be the beginning of reviving the culture that was.